This journey began around 18, 19 years back, I would say, because before that I was recycling textile chemical waste. So these waste we would take from textile dyes and chemicals and processing unit of textiles and all. So I've been recycling that waste. In a chemical dyeing, you usually use more than 8,000 chemicals in one shirt, which is phenomenal quantity of chemical use and also the pollutant which comes out from that. So the only alternative would have been to use something natural, which is biodegradable or biocompostable. So our search went into finding a process which brought us to natural dyeing, which took us a lot of years to actually master that art. What we use is basically more of recipes which has been suggested in Ayurveda. It's Ayurvedic ancient script which is we have in India also mentions a lot of these natural dye recipes which can be used. Similarly, there are recipes proposed in all different part of the world in different technique of natural dyeing, including Egyptian dyeing, English dyeing, or even a European dyeing in certain continents and UK, England. They had their own recipes. So these recipes come from the wild plants which we use. Though in certain cases we are also using madder for red, which comes from the root. And indigo is very well known, which is cultivated throughout in India for a long time now. Otherwise, like pomegranate peels are used, harda used, marabalum is used as a fruit. So like this, there are a lot of other minerals also which is naturally available in abundant. Chemical dyeing is bad for health and environment, but how much, how horrific it is, I would not have known unless I would have seen it on my, with my eyes, practically when I was recycling textile chemical waste. So ruining a 2,500 liter of water, drinking water for making one t-shirt dye. So there is an urgent need of replacing chemical dyes with natural dyes. But it's a long way ahead and we need people's support and understanding for that. So I think one of the challenges is to make people aware. I believe when the demand and the value of natural dye increases, people will start wearing it. So awareness is one of the blockages. We are doing our best to do that, and there are other people I believe also working on that. So if we can combine both awareness and the technology, it will bring wonders to people, to the environment and the surroundings for us. Natural colors are color which is from nature, which also changes amazingly. If you see the same color here or you see the same color in Europe, it will look different because of its natural ability to absorb the UV rays and the reflectors and all. So it has its own beauty, which chemical dyeing will not have. So if we go by natural dyes, it is good for your skin because you're not absorbing the chemical which is there in chemical dyeing. Here you're absorbing, in fact, healthy amines in your body, which is good and medicinal for your use. You're not ruining the drinking water. And it has its own color value. It has its own property. It is speaking to you, your body. The color is speaking through nature. What more beautiful it can be to wear a cloth made out of the natural dyes than anything else. Fiber biodone. So that made us so much happy and proud to see that the way you have developed it for 2 years, working hard and understanding the point. We need people like you or people like aware people who are able to take this message forward with the right tone.